part of this.
What is it?
It's the Rockin' Metal Revival! It's medication for erectile dysfunction. It gives you a boner.
Crank it up!
Not to be used if you have a pre-existing heart condition. If boners last for more than 4 hours, call more ladies.
Horns up, metalheads. It's time for another edition of Rock and Metal Revival. We are back for actually a real version. I mean, last week, that was kind of cool, but I have some complaints about the fireworks and the lining up of the music, my friend.
Yeah. Well, like I said, man, it all depended on the length of your fuse.
Oh, okay.
So all right, if you didn't get the email that I sent out to the whole world, then, you know, it all depends. You had to light it at just the right time, you know? It's kind of like that Pink Floyd and the Wizard of Oz thing, you know?
You
got to start it at the right time or the things don't line up. So, you know, you can't put that on me.
All right.
When everybody's drinking and they're not thinking right
now. Yeah, they're just not on it. I get it. On today's show, we got Mark LaBelle, the lead vocalist of the band Dirty Honey. And if you haven't checked out Dirty Honey yet, we had the guitar player on here. Boy, what is it? Almost, what, 7-8 months ago?
Yeah, it's at least 6 months ago or so when it first came out. And it's still out, still doing good, it looks like.
Yeah, it's still doing well. And they were actually just getting ready to head in to record a new full-length album. And everything got shut down. So we'll talk to Mark next hour. And we've got some new music for you. We've got that BPMD. I'm kind of digging that CD.
Oh, yeah.
I'm liking it a lot.
I got the vinyl the other day. It's cool.
Did you
Very
really?
Very cool. Oh, yeah. Yeah. If I like something, you got to support the music, man. You got to go buy it. Otherwise, you know, they're all going to just fade away. When everybody's just listening to Spotify and they get a portion of a penny, you know, every 100,000 listens, you know, it just doesn't make any sense, man. Come on. Support your artist.
All right. Well, we'll talk to Mark next hour. And, I'm trying to look. We got some great tunes this week. The other day I was listening to this album. I love this album. I had a little road trip I had to do last Friday, and I was listening to Tesla's Psychotic Supper.
Oh, nice.
And I heard this song, and I'm like, man, we got to throw this on the playlist.
Okay.
This is Freedom Slaves from Tesla, kicking off this edition of Rockin' Metal Revival. From their own family tree, there's Blackstone Cherry and Bad Habit on Rock and Metal Revival, and some people could probably say, listen to this show, it's a bad habit.
It could be. Could be.
Yeah.
If you're expecting information or education, any kind of thing to better your life, yeah, not really. Other than music.
Not really, no.
Other than some good music, other than that, you know. Might discover some new artists and stuff, but yeah, as long as you're not looking for information just to be informative or anything.
Exactly.
Okay.
And, hey, man, what'd you do for your 4th of July?
Not much. I listened to a lot of fireworks in the neighborhood.
I have to give my subdivision credit. I think it was better than the city would have put on anyways.
Nice, nice. Yeah, yeah. There's a lot going on around here, too.
Man, that's where, you know, we probably should have stuck our money into it was fireworks this past probably month and a half, because I'll tell you what, people spent a lot of money on it.
Yeah, it sure sounded like it, man.
Yeah, wow, definitely. It was crazy.
It's like
and
a war zone.
It's been hotter than hell, too, lately.
Yeah, I wonder what's up with that. Oh, well, it is July.
Oh, it is July, but you know what? If you think about it, the last couple summers, we usually get a hot day here and a hot day there. It's been hot for like 10 days now.
Well, it's better than snow.
Yeah, well, and I got relatives that are out in Phoenix that go, hey, it's 115 here today. I'm like, hey, good for you. That's why you live in a desert.
Yeah.
You wanted it hot. It's congratulations.
Dry heat, so it must feel like 50.
Yeah, stick your head in the oven, man. That's dry heat, too, but I'm not doing that.
It feels like 50 if it's dry heat, right?
Yeah. Hey, man, I was in Vegas one time. It was 110 degrees. It was damn hot.
Oh.
That's all I know.
Yep, I've been there before, and it's like, no thanks.
Crazy stuff. All right, coming up on the show, we've got our News of the Weird, we've got our Talking Real Metal, and we've got some good stuff. Let's play that BPMD tune.
Oh,
tell everybody who's in that band.
Oh, Bobby Blitz, Ellsworth from Overkill, right? Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Bobby Blitz from Overkill, yeah.
And then Mike Portnoy from every band that's out there right now. He's their drummer. And then Mark Mann, I don't even know who this bass player is.
Yeah.
But he's the guy who produced the whole thing and came up with the whole idea. Mangini or something like that.
Mangini?
Yeah, there you go. Who'd he play with? I don't remember who he played with.
With a band.
He was in a band. He was in somebody's band at some point.
Well, let's just put it this way. You can find out more next week when Bobby Blitz is interviewed by Jerry.
Yeah, and Phil Demmel is the guitarist. And, yeah, like I said, if you're looking for being informative, yeah.
Yeah, you're not going to get it here.
I didn't know it was going to be a quiz. I would have prepared.
This is the classic Ted Nugent song from BPMD from their album American Made. This is Wang Dang Sweet Poon Tang on Rockin' Metal Revival. There's brand new music from Dee Snider for The Love of Metal live, and that is Prove Me Wrong on Rockin' Metal Revival. And you know what? I think Dee should keep doing what he's doing, man. I'm really liking his new solo stuff.
Yeah, it's a lot heavier than the Twisted Sister stuff, and he's using his voice different, which is kind of, I like a lot better. So
It is very cool. I liked it since the first, what was the last album, that last album he put out? I thought it was great.
For The Love of Metal.
Yeah, this is live, and the last one was, that was just a great album.
Some good stuff. A lot more aggressive.
Didn't he do, what was that one band you were playing that he was part of, didn't it?
He was a singer for Widowmaker.
Yes.
And their first album was awesome. And it's hard to find. Yeah. You can't find it anywhere.
Yeah, it's hard to find, yeah. That is true. All right, it's time now for another episode of News of the Weird, and it just keeps getting weirder. The world is such a weird place. We start out today, Jerry, in Japan, all right? And this guy has a horrible pickup technique, okay?
Uh-oh.
And it's apparently he has a pretty bad memory, too. There's a 32-year-old guy named Yoshito Harada, and he lives in Japan, and his way of trying to meet women was by slashing their tires.
Okay, and then what?
Okay, he'd slash their tires and then drive up offering them help to help them out to get back in to their cars. He pulled that move on a 43-year-old woman while she was grocery shopping a few weeks ago, and she thought it was suspicious because the exact same thing happened to her a year earlier.
He might want to have a better memory about that. Maybe mark down license plates or something.
Yep, apparently Yoshito already had tried to slash the tires and rescue move on this woman and forgot. She reported it to police and they tracked down Yoshito. Get this, it turns out he's been busted for this at least two times before, and his lawyer admitted he probably pulled this move over 1,000 times.
Wow. Does he also run a tire repair place?
That's what I was wondering, yeah.
And, or he's always carrying an extra spare with him.
And here's the thing, man, and he's clearly failed at every one of these because he is still single. They have not even come up with all the charges. They're waiting for all the women now to come forth who have had running with Yoshito.
Oh, Yoshito, shame on you. Man.
Yoshito is in a lot of trouble.
Yeah, if it doesn't work after four or five times, dude.
Yeah.
You know, I'd give it up, but
get a new line or something. Yeah. All right. Now we go to the state of Kentucky, where you never underestimate the power of being drunk and competitive.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Okay. A 55-year-old guy named Curtis Zimmerman in Florence, Kentucky, was drunk this past Sunday night and decided to arm wrestle his son. Now, we don't know the son's age. We just know that he's under the age of 18, all right?
Okay.
Well, the kid kicked his dad's ass at arm wrestling, and Curtis was so angry, they started fighting for real. And then Curtis grabbed his gun and fired two shots into the ceiling while his son was upstairs.
No.
Yeah, seriously. The cops went out to the house around 1 a.m. on Monday morning and got into an 8-hour standoff with old Curtis before he finally surrendered. He's been charged with endangerment to a minor, resisting arrest, And what is this? Something misuse of a firearm.
Yeah. Yeah. Jeez. Really? Just, oh, man.
Keep that in mind, kids, if you're listening out there. Don't beat the old man at hoops.
Yeah.
Or arm wrestling.
Yeah. Let him win. Just okay. You know, let him have his pride.
Yeah.
Because it could cost you in the end.
Could cost you a place to live.
Yeah.
Hey, Jerry, when was the last bachelor party you went on?
Ah, dude, I don't remember. I don't think I've been on it.
Well, you know how they go.
Yeah,
you do crazy stuff.
Oh, yeah,
right?
Yeah.
You know, it's all fun and games until someone gets hurt or gets their tongue bitten by a snake.
Oh, they're what? Bitten by a snake?
A German man was having a bachelor party in the Austrian Alps.
They do it crazy I guess.
Yeah, where strippers and beer clearly weren't enough.
Okay.
On a dare, the 38-year-old groom-to-be was challenged to touch a baby viper on the floor with his tongue.
Yikes.
Well, apparently, this idiot, the snake had a couple thoughts on the matter and bit the guy right in the tongue.
Yeah.
Causing it to swell up so much that he couldn't get it back into his mouth.
Oh.
They had to call the Red Cross, and the staff from the Red Cross said the partygoers may have confused the young snake with a large inchworm.
Oh, no. they thought it was something else, and it turned out to be a bug.
Hey, I don't care where I'm at. I'm not touching any worm with my tongue.
No, no.
Not happening.
No, that's just wrong to begin with.
Yeah, and last but not least, this story, Jerry, you're a fan of the Fonz, right?
Oh. Hey. Oh, yeah.
Now,
you're
familiar with the Beatles, right?
I've heard of them. Yeah.
All right, well, get this. The Beatles almost got back together in 1976, 6 years after they broke up.
Oh, yeah?
But their reunion was prevented by a great white shark.
No way.
According to Ringo Starr, a promoter offered them the equivalent in 1976 of about $250 million in today's money.
Oh.
And the four of them actually talked about this.
They were going to do it, huh?
According to Ringo, we called each other to see what we all thought. We decided not to do it because the opening act was actually a guy fighting a shark in a tank, so we said no. It sounds crazy, but there might be some truth to this. According to a People magazine article from 1976, a promoter named Bill Sargent made the offer, but after the Beatles turned him down, he decided to concentrate on his next project, in which an Australian diver named Wally Gibbons would, quote, fight to the death with a 14-foot, 2,500-pound great white shark in a lagoon off of Western Samoa.
Yikes.
So the Beatles decided, unlike Fonzie, not to jump the shark.
Oh, man. Because, see, what I thought is they didn't want to do the concert because they were all going to stay home and watch Happy Days because Fonzie was jumping a shark.
Well, I tell you what, that's probably what they did. All right, now, and that ends up News of the Weird. So coming up, we've got some Talking Real Metal, and then next hour we'll talk to Mark LaBelle of the band Dirty Honey, right here on Rock and Metal Revival.
Here's your latest hard rock and metal news on Rock and Metal Revival.
Horns up, metalheads. It's time once again for another edition of Talking Real Metal. That's right, your hard rock and metal news. And for all you kids in summer school, get your pens and papers out because there will be a test.
Oh, man, and it's a doozy. There's like 400 questions on this one.
Yeah, and they're all multiple choice.
No, they're all 50-word answers.
Yeah, all right, I quit already. All right, Derek Sharnan's The Phoenix album to include some pretty heavy-duty guests, Steve Vai, Zakk Wylde, and Billy Sheehan.
Nice, man. I remember when we first started doing the show, he put out an album with Zakk. We had Zakk Wylde, had a bunch of guests on it, because he's an awesome keyboardist. He was a keyboardist for Dream Theater and stuff, so the dude can, you know, he can make it sound like a guitar. He can play anything. Just a brilliant dude, man. That album was pretty cool back then, so hey.